సీనియర్ ఏఎఫ్ రిటైర్ 10 సంవత్సరాలు అయింది. స్వచ్ఛలతి హ్యాస్ లాంగ్ అండ్ బట్ హీ హ్యాస్ లాంగ్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ ఇన్ ద ఫీల్డ్ ఆఫ్ ఫైనాన్స్. He has worked as senior AFA in finance for several years. He has also worked as DGM in the RSDA. And presently he is consulting faculty at and he said, over to Mr. Abdulati. Participants, please pay some time because I'm taking the yes, sir. Abdul sir, good morning. Please take over for session, sir. Abdul sir, can you hear me?
Good morning, how are you?
Yes, fine, sir. We have just made a small introduction. You can now start the class.
One second. Voice is not loud enough. Am I very audible to you?
Yeah.
Voice is good.
Your voice is clear, sir.
Acha. So let me increase my voice. One second. Classes, especially during this lockdown, it will be useful for everybody. Useful for the people who are working in finance section, people who are working in connected sections, and who are preparing for the examinations. And we must know, actually, as an accounts man, we must know the process, we must know the procedures. So this is a good initiative. I congratulate Sundar and our additional director of Sitara for this initiative. Very good.
All great boost to our Dean sir.
Yeah, Dean sir, I know. Special thanks to Dean, special congratulations to Dean. So, okay. So, the topic given to me is the works program. Works program, there have been a lot of changes and recently the works program, PWP as such. What is PWP? PWP is a process for sending the proposals to board for inclusion in the works budget. So we will see that. First we will try to understand, recap which did actually. There are so many accounts assistants, there are so many JAs I have seen. So, let us know what with the classification of expenditure, broad classification. All of you know that Indian Railways expenditure. You know, all of you know our earnings are XYZ, the transportation of goods, passengers and miscellaneous. And to achieve that transportation, to achieve the aim of the main business of Indian Railways, that is transportation, we need to incur expenditure on various aspects. We need to create assets, we need to maintain those assets, we need to pay the establishment, we need to have the operational costs. So much expenditure is there. So the expenditure is broadly classified into two categories. One is capital and one is revenue. So the capital expenditure is the creation of assets, the expenditure required on creation of assets, the replacements of assets, and purchase of new M&P, purchase of new rolling stock. So the entire expenditure for creation of assets will be charged to capital. Again, I'm telling you why I'm repeating this, because there are so many young accounts people are there who have just joined. Probably they are also there in the team. So that's why, for the sake of them, I'm just repeating the classification of expenditure, that is the capital and the revenue. So we have created assets. So for maintenance of those assets, we require some expenditure. That expenditure is classified as revenue. Expenditure on maintenance of the assets, including establishment, operation, and maintenance and miscellaneous expenses, that will come under revenue. One more, it's not a different category. Part of revenue is a special revenue. It's a special revenue. This is the expenditure incurred on emergency restoration of track, restoration of communication during floods, earthquakes, and natural calamities. So there we treat that expenditure as special revenue. It's not a revenue. It is a special revenue. So these are the broad classification of expenditure on Indian Railways. So on other ministries, that capital is called plan expenditure, and the revenue expenditure is called the non-plan expenditure. So we know the classification of expenditure, and we should also know how do we get this budget for this expenditure? How do we get money for this expenditure? We have known that the classification expenditure, how do we get the money? For revenue expenditure, the process is very simple. Most of you know. During REV, we will assess our requirements depending on our grant given to that particular year. Either we surrender, or we ask more, or we don't ask anything. So that is as far as the revenue expenditure. This is based on your the trend of expenditure during that particular financial year. The trend of expenditure. And any special things that require, we will take into account all those things, and then we assess the revenue expenditure. This is very simple. Based on your grant, based on your expenditure for the 7 months or half a year, whatever, then you see what is the amount required for me in the next financial, during the financial year and for remaining months. And if you require more, you ask more. If you don't require, you don't ask anything. If you feel that your grant is more, then you surrender it. That is as far as the current financial year is concerned. The next financial year, so you'll also ask the same on the same lines. So budget for revenue is over. It's a very simple process. That is over. Whereas the expenditure on capital, the expenditure on works, the expenditure on demand number 16 is different. It depends on the number of works you propose. It depends on the works in progress you have. You have huge sanction of works during last 10 years, during last 5 years. Some part of the works were completed. The remaining we have some throw forward. So whatever expenditure required for works in progress and the expenditure required for new works. So your expenditure under capital head, under works demand, depends on the number of works you propose. Depends on the number of throw forward, the amount of throw forward you have in your various planets. So this is the difference. So revenue expenditure basically it is on trend and the special features, and the works expenditure depends on your number of works you propose during the financial year and the amount you required for completion of the ongoing. So I think this is very clear. Then next we will go. Before I go into the details of works program, so let me also discuss about the changes. Recent, there have been some changes. We have we have merged with the central government budget. We used to have our own budget and we used to present our own budget, but now we have to. We have already merged, and we have various demands for grants. We have 16 demands for grants. Demand number 16 represent the capital demand. Demand number 1 to 15, they are the revenue demands. So for revenue demands, we know how to project our expenditure, REB state, and then for capital demand, we have to plan. The expenditure depends on the number of works we propose. So these were the demands, but these demands now have been modified. These demands have been mapped, merged with some other major head and the sub-major head. So as far as the railways accounting, railway system is concerned, we are still following the S12 demand. We call it S12 demand, but we are still following that. Only for the purpose of mapping our requirements with the central budget, we use this major heads and sub-major heads. This is done basically at the headquarters level and the railway boards level. So as far as the divisions, as far as the working is concerned, we still follow these existing demands, because there is no correction made to our classification of expenditure. So as long as there is no correction is made, so our system will continue to adopt this. For the purpose of asking funds from board, it is mapped with the new major heads and new heads. So here we had 16 demands for grants. And these 16 demands for grant have been grouped into three major heads. One is the Indian Railways Policy Direction and Research, another. This is 1 and 2. Demand number X12, 1 and 2 have been merged as 3001. And demand number 3 to 14, they have been merged into 3002, Indian Railways Commercial Lines Working Expenses. So there is demand number 15, of course, we don't have to pay any dividends these days. That is classified as major head 305, and we have demand number 16. We have 5001 for the strategic lines and 5002 for the commercial lines. So these are the major heads under which our proposals will be submitted to the parliament. And under these major heads, we have again sub major heads. 3001 railway board, 3001 miscellaneous expenses, and we have demand number 3 to 14, they have been mapped as 1 to 12 for the purpose of asking money under revenue. So these are the mapping of the demand, erstwhile demands with the new major head and new sub-major head. So we will not discuss about the revenue, because the process of revenue budgeting is very simple. And we will discuss about the capital budgeting. Capital budgeting works program. Works budgeting. It is nothing but works budgeting. You can call it demand number budget under demand number 2, works demand, or demand number 16, or capital demand. All these are one and the same. So under capital segment, under works demand, we have various plan heads to, you know, what is the classification of expenditure under capital. These are all now called minor heads of capital. One was this demand number 16 was called as this major head, and these plan heads are called the minor heads under sub major head demand 16. So we have various plan heads: new lines, gauge conversion, doubling, traffic facilities, computation, RSP. RSP doesn't form part of the works program. That's why I have made it red. Capital component doesn't form of the works program. Basically, it is a component of capital only, but it doesn't form part of the works program. And then we have other planned S&T, RE, other electrical works, MNP workshops. There is no TRD works now. And these two demands, planned 5100 and 52 have been merged. Now it is a new planet called staff welfare. So all these planets, these are all planets. So we require money under these planets, under the works falling under these planets. So you know what is a new line, what is a gauge conversion, everybody knows. What are the traffic facilities? But traffic facilities are nothing but the works required for operational improvements in the yard modifications, construction of a crossing station. So these are all come under the traffic facilities, computerization, you know. And railway safety works are there, LC gates, ROVs, REBs, track and works required, replacement of complete track, replacement of rails, replacement of sleepers, fittings, all those commander track renewal works. Track bridges are there. There are existing bridges, those required to be replaced, strengthened. SLT works are there, electrical works are there. So the works falling under these planets will have to be planned. Works falling under these planets will have to. So now, for the capital segment of budgeting, like for demand number 16, we have capital segment, then we have the various planets. Under various planets, we have works. So those works will be processed for inclusion in the budget. So this process is called the works program. So the process is not this much, it is very elaborate. We'll discuss all those processes. As per our engineering code, the planning of major projects. There are major projects and minor projects. You know, in the Indian Railways, we have major projects like new lines is a major project, doubling is a major project, railway electrification is a major project, gauge conversion is a major project, and construction of a workshop is a major project. So for major projects, you require to have the feasibility studies. You require to have surveys. Feasibility studies are nothing but the surveys. You have various types of surveys. So feasibility surveys, studies, surveys have to be taken up by railway for undertaking. Mute your audio. There is some disturbance coming. I request all the participants to mute their videos. Sorry, not videos, audio. We can have videos on, but audio. Whenever you want to ask any question, you can unmute and then ask. But during the process, I think some other disturbances will come. So please mute your audio. So, what are the investigation of viability of projects? It is nothing but the survey reports, various types of survey reports. We have the preliminary survey, we have the reconnaissance survey, we have the PETs. All those surveys are nothing but the process of viability of projects. Then, based on the survey reports, a decision will be taken. And for inclusion of the survey reports in the budget also, the works have to be processed. To the board for inclusion in demand number 2, not in the demand number 16 capital, but to undertake, suppose some demand has come for construction of new line, there is some public demand, there is some political representations, there is some economical growth in that section, so which may be useful to the railways in generating additional revenue. So such proposals will be sent to board, and it will be placed at different platforms, and then there somebody will take a decision. Okay, so let us do some feasibility study on these particular projects. So, but doing the feasibility study, the work will be first included in the demand number 2. After it is included in the demand number 2, then the survey will be taken. Generally, what happens? Every budget, as soon as the budget is announced, they'll see the budget and then they'll see, okay, new line between this A to B new line. For our state, we have got some 6 projects, new line projects. It doesn't mean that the projects have been sanctioned under demand number 16. They have been only included under demand number 2 for taking up the survey. But probably the state government, they are not aware of this process of Indian Railways. So they think that if the work is included in the demand number 2, they think that it is sanctioned. Nevertheless, so we have taken a decision to undertake that work. So that's why we have included in the demand number 2. So the pre-investment appraisals are survey estimates are nothing but project upside estimates. We will see what are the various estimates detailedly. So what we have, the upside estimates and we have the project upside estimates. So the surveys are nothing but project upside estimates. They are prepared based on the process of project assessment, investigation and technical issues, evaluation and selection of a particular line or scheme. So these are mandatory for major projects like new lines, doubling, RE and PUs. It is chargeable to, as I discussed already, it is chargeable to demand number 2. That is sub-major 3001 being miscellaneous expenses, and it shall be charged to the work concerned if the project is sanctioned and executed under S5D number 16. So viable projects after approval of competent authority will be included in the budget. What is the viable project? Here viable project means a project after the survey is done is expected to yield not less than 10% ROR is called the viable project. I request again, please mute yourself, mute your mics so that there will not be any disturbance.
What is a viable project?
What is viable project is nothing but a project after the survey, after the financial justification, should give at least 10% rate of return on the investment.
Okay, sir.
The ROR should be, how to work out ROR is a different, as we will have the financial, how a financial justification is arrived at. But for our purpose today, viable project is nothing but a project which gives more than 10% ROR. Earlier it was 14%, maybe it's 10%. So the levels of investment. So this brief description was necessary for the works program. That's why I'm just covering some important points so that you will not be having some confusion. It will be very clear. So we should also know the level of investments. Of course, this may not be required for the examination purpose, but you must know at least the general manager can approve a project, a small work of 2.5 crores because of some grant. He can approve a work under umbrella of 2.5 crores. He can approve a out of turn work of 2.5 crores. So the powers of general manager are restricted to basically 2.5 crores each. Anything beyond 2.5 crores, except a couple of planets, the work should go to railway board. And the railway, in the railway board, they are examined at different levels and approved at different levels. See, up to 100 crores, this CRB takes a decision. Up to 500 crores, the MOR, with the recommendation of the board, they'll take a decision. And costing more than 500 to 1000 crores, it is Minister of Railways, again, with the expanded board of members. So, board members, recommendation of board members is different from recommendation of the expanded board of members. So, board members, you know how many board members are there? So they will recommend for that project. Expanded board includes a member from the Niti Aayog, Planning Commission, because for major projects we may be requiring funds under capital. And beyond 1,000 crores, it requires to be approved by the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs. So they will approve the major projects costing more than 1,000 crores and with the recommendation of the expanded board. So these are the basic levels of investments. Here, what you must remember is, up to 2.5 crores, it is general manager, and beyond 2.5 crores, it is board. So in the board, they will decide depending on the value. Works program is nothing but the investment planning and works budget. It is a works budget. We know the revenue budget, how it is processed simply during the REB stage. I have already briefed that. And for the purpose of works, we have to process the works. We have to process with justification. We have to process with details for the approval of different authorities, what I discussed now. So, the works budget, the works program is nothing but formulation of schemes as part of the advanced planning. We have to process this works program is not a short time measure. It is advanced planning throughout the year. People will be working on the various projects. People will be working on the various proposals. So it is a grassroots level. The DN knows what kind of work he has to undertake to safeguard the interest of the railways, to safeguard the assets of the railways. So he will be sending his proposal, sir, there is some bridge is damaged, so you please, this bridge has to be replaced for the safety of the track. So he will put his proposal, to the headquarters or to his senior DN. So he knows the track condition, he knows the bridge conditions. So he knows the condition of the quarters, he knows the condition of the various assets. So it is a planning done at the grassroots level. And as far as small works are concerned, so it can be done even in the lump sum works program, it can be done in the umbrella works. But for the major schemes, advanced planning is required. This work has to be included in the demand number 2 for taking up the survey. So preparation of the preliminary works program has to be done within the financial ceiling to be fixed by the board. What they'll do, they'll say, they'll first issue a letter. The process of works program begins like this. The process of works program is nothing but proposing the works for inclusion in the budget. So for proposing the works and the budget required for the works in progress, the railway board will ask the various zonal railways to submit their proposals. So that is called the works program process. So the works program, it is divided into preliminary works program, final works program, and we will discuss the other issues. So preliminary works program. Preliminary works program, first they'll issue some ceilings. The board will say, see, under plan at 1600, you have got this grant, and suppose you have got some 50 crores grant under one planet. So board will say, you please send the proposals within 100 crores. Actually, there is a ceiling prescribed in the MSOP. There is a ceiling prescribed in the engineering code also. The ceiling is your grant of the railway under planet into the NAM minus throw forward. That should be the ceiling. But these days, ceilings are not being followed. They are not being followed. Why they are not being followed, we discuss later. So, and board gives a letter like this. They'll give. I'll show you the letter first. See, this is the letter. This is the letter gives every month issued by the Civil Engineering Directorate. They'll say processing of works program. This is, I have taken the latest letter on the works program 2122. I request the members again to mute their audio. So here they say, this is the board letter. I have taken the extract of the board letter. They say, the annual exercise. Participants are requested to mute. Participants are requested. Getting a voice which is disturbing. So participants are requested to mute their audio. So here, this is the letter based on which the works program process commences. The board says the annual exercise of works program for the financial year should be undertaken by railways. They are saying that. The railways, what they are saying? They are saying railways focus should be on completion of the already sanctioned budget, because nowadays we are having the problem of funds. So board says that the railways focus should be on completion of already sanctioned works, so as to complete them in a time-bound manner and utilize the investment made by railways. Zonal railways are therefore advised not to propose new works. So board now saying that you don't propose any new works in works program 2021. This has been there for the last 3 years. So every year they are saying you don't propose any new works. You try to utilize the funds for the completion of the ongoing works. Except very, they are also saying that you don't propose any new works except very important additional works related to safe running of trains. So whatever you propose should be safe running of trains. So board further state desires that a critical review of all sanctioned works must be carried out over railways, and all such works which are not required in present scenario may be dropped, frozen or processed for deletion, freezing at the board's level. So they are also giving a direction that because the funds constraint are there, so you please review your works and if possible drop them and freeze them. And they are also saying that from year 2018-19 onward, the concept of umbrella works has been introduced. What is umbrella work? We'll discuss. So detailed procedure. So what you do is now you send the proposals to us, and we will pick up the works under each umbrella and include in the budget. So as per the existing directives, the PWB proposals are not being vetted by finance. They are being directly sent to board through IRPSM. But the system will not continue. Sometime it has to be revoked and finance has to check those proposals. So for the time being, because this umbrella works concept is in vogue, see, the PWP is not being vetted by finance. Okay, so this is, and there are, they are saying volume 1, 2, 3. So this PWB is submitted to the board in three volumes. Volume 1 is the works funds required for works in progress, volume 1. Volume 2 is the new work, the emergency works, the works required for safety of track or the assets. So those are required to be submitted under PWB volume 2. And volume 3, all track renewal works, all track renewal works are submitted to the board under volume 3. So this is the board letter, and we have to process accordingly. We have to process the PWB accordingly. Okay, so one more thing before we go, how the PWB process begins, we must also know the source of funding. Briefly I'll discuss what are the various sources of funding. So we have earnings with us, and those earnings we will not spend for the works. Those earnings we will use for the expenses on revenue demands, and we use those earnings for reappropriation to various funds. So here, so the classification of source fund, the ordinary revenue expenditure on demand over 1 to 15. So it is not that whatever you are earning, you should spend it. You have to budget it. You have to budget and submit to the board and ask grant. To that extent only you can spend under under revenue expenditure. So this is all your demand over 1 to 15 or 14. It is nothing but your internal revenues, right? They are internal, you are earning, so you are spending. Whereas the demand number 16 has various sources of funding. Generally, whenever you take up a new work, you need to work out an ROR of rate of return. We must see that I'm investing some 100 crores here, what is that I'm going to get back? Either in terms of the additional revenue or in terms of the savings. So you must work out the ROR. How to work out ROR under DCM technique? So, whatever works giving more than 10% ROR, we will propose under capital. We'll ask the relevant board to give grant for these new works. Suppose but the whatever amount we have asked is given by the parliament or the relevant board, then our all new schemes will be charged to capital, and that is the nothing but the budgetary support given by the government of India. All the capital expenditure is budgetary support, and then so we also have some capital fund. These days the balance is very meager. So suppose any amount left over, we'll also use for this interest passing and giving more than 10% ROR for capital fund also. Generally, we used to use this for rolling stock program. So we also have a fund called DRF. All the replacement of the existing assets, we charge it to DRF, and the source is the internal source here again. So DF1 is the passenger amenity works required on passenger amenities, and it is also internal source. So we'll be appropriating every year from our revenues. And DF2 is the expenditure on staff amenities, DF3, the expenditure on unremunerative works. Remunerative works, here we said more than 10% ROR if any work is giving, that is called remunerative work, and that work should be charged to capital. But every work, we may not get 10% ROR. There will be some works which are giving only 5 to 6%, but they are essentially required. It is required for operational efficiency. Those works we charge into DF3 here. And we have DF4, all the safety works. So DF4, that is also internal resource. Then we have the safety fund. This is the budgetary support from the central government, which we are using for level crossings, removal of level crossing, ROBs, RUBs. And we also have on RSK, Rashtriya Rail Samraksha Kosh. It's a 1 lakh crore amount given by the government of India, which is to be spent over a period of 5 years, and every year they'll use 15,000-20,000 crores. So that amount we have to spend on replacement of existing assets on safety considerations. And apart from that, we also have an EBR. This is extra budget resources. This is nothing but you say finance provided by the IRFC, and this is used for projects costing more than 10% ROR. And around 65 to 70% of the capital plan outlay. Our capital expenditure, capex. Suppose our capex is 150 crores. The 65% of that amount comes from the finances. So the position of Indian Railways as far as the finances is concerned, it is not that bright. So we are mostly depending on the extra budgetary resources. We are creating the assets by getting the finance from the IRFC. You know the difference between a work undertaken with budgetary support and a work undertaken with the finance. Suppose 100 kilometers line we are constructing through capital. That means that line belongs to the railways. It is our asset. Whereas suppose if we are constructing the same 100 kilometers line with the finances given by the IRFC, the line is not ours. So the line will be constructed and leased to railways. It is a leased asset to the railway. It is not the railway owned asset. So till you repay the leased amount and along with the interest, the asset is not yours. So this is the difference between asset created out of capital and asset created out of EBR. So basic, there are types of estimate, offset estimate, detailed estimates. So today we will discuss about the offset estimates. Today we will discuss about the project estimates because these are connected with the works program. Everybody knows, I think, all these types of estimates. I need not again tell the details about that. If anybody wants to have, if you have any doubt, please ask. So offset estimates on open line, project offset estimates on construction site, that is major projects, are connected with the works program, are connected with the works program. Basically, all offset estimates are open line only, connected with the works program. Construction estimates are sent, the project offset estimates in the form of surveys are sent separately to the railway board, and the board decides to take up any project. It will be directly included in the King Book generally. It doesn't come through works program. It doesn't come through the works program sent every year by the railway. It is directly included in the budget under the finance. So for open line offset estimates, we have to process through PWP, we have to process through FWP, and gets included in the big book. Whereas for the projects, generally all the projects have to be surveyed, and survey reports have to be sent separately, duly vetted by finance to the board, and board at a different levels, they take a decision whether to take up that work or not. If they decide to take up the work, that work gets included directly in the thing. So basically the PWP is limited to the offset estimates of the zonal railways, offset estimates of the open line, costing up to generally 500 crores. Beyond 500 crores, you need to have survey. Okay. So PWP is the process, PWP is the work program. Works program consists of PWP. So PWP is the process for making the proposals, works proposals, making the proposals to the board for inclusion in the pink book. This is the process. And how the process is done? It is done through IRPSM. There is a software called IRPSM. So I've also included in this PPT the different process. What is the process in the division? What is the process in the headquarters? What is the process in the railway board? All those details I have included. If we have time, we'll discuss that. So now we'll discuss first the offset estimate, because offset estimate is the part of the works program. It is nothing. The work is nothing but an offset estimate. I am proposing a new work. That is nothing but an offset estimate. Offset estimates are prepared for the purpose of getting the administrative approval of competent authority. Offset estimates are prepared. These are the rough estimates, sketches, plans, prepared for the purpose of getting the administrative approval of the competent authority. So, how do we get this administrative approval? Through PWP. How this PWP process? Through IRPSM. So processing the offset estimates for the approval of competent authority through PWP is called the works program. It's called the works program. And you know the limits, financial limits, I already told you, up to 2.5 crores, GM can approve, except a couple of planets. And beyond 2.5 crores, it has to go to the railway board. It has to go to the railway board, duly vetted by, not duly vetted, these days of course, the estimates are not being vetted. But the actual procedure is, all the estimates, all the abstract estimates which are being processed through PWP have to be vetted, have to be sent to board with the comments of FNCO. So based on the FNCO's verbatim comments, the works will get, will be shortlisted there, and then it gets included in the big book. Or suppose we have sent some 100 works, we will be sending the proposals under each panel. We will be discussing that. Then how does the FWP, how does PWP becomes the FWP, and how Pink Book is prepared, and how does the LSWP is generated, what is an umbrella work, all these things we will discuss subsequently. So investment planning and works budget, that is part of the PWP. So advanced planning is there, scrutiny of schemes before PWP, processing PWP through IRPSM, preliminary works program, volume 1, 2, 3. Volume 1 is works in progress, volume 2 is the new works, volume 3 is the works pertaining to Planet 3100. There is volume 4 also, that is not that significant. Volume 4 is nothing but index, some letters, some additional information to support the PWP. In olden days, we used to carry all these volumes, volume 1, volume 2, volume 3, we used to go to railway board. We used to hire a coach actually, not hire a coach, we used to take a coach. Each railway will have a coach wherein these volumes, voluminous books, we used to carry to the board and sit at New Delhi on the platforms. And then whenever we are given some slot, individual railways we used to be given some slot. So we used to rush these PWP volumes to the board, and then the works used to be shortlisted. That was a big process, but after this IRPSM has come, the process has been very reduced, and the paperwork has been reduced, the manual work has been reduced. Of course, there are some limitations in the works, in the IRPSM that we'll discuss also. So whatever works we propose under preliminary works program, under various planets, suppose under planet 16 is the traffic facilities, or we take up the planet 5300. 5300 is the planet passenger abilities. So there we have sent some 100 works to the board, costing more than 2.5 crores. So what they have done, board will examine it various levels, depending on the cost it will be examined. There will be AMS committee, there will be different committees at the board. There will be nodal directorates. So after getting it scrutinized at various levels, the works will be shortlisted. We have sent 100 proposals, but 100 proposals will not be approved, because we are running short of funds also. So out of 100, only 10 proposals have been included, shortlisted. So those 10 proposals, they will ask the railways to submit the final works program. So PWP of 100 works have been reduced to 10 works, which is the basis for preparing the FWP. So now preparing again FWP used to take a lot of time. Now it's only shortlisting and making proposals in the IRPSM, so we submit the FWP. So FWP is the basis for preparing the Pink Book. There we are asking what is the amount required for the ongoing works, what is the amount, what are the works, 10 works have been approved. So those 10 works will be included in the Pink Book as an itemized work. So whatever works costing more than 2.5 crores included in the Pink Book are called itemized works. So these days we must know what is an itemized work, what is a lump sum work, what is the umbrella work, and what is the OT work. These are very important, because you will be using this terminology very frequently in the working of railways. Suppose somebody tells you this is an itemized work, so you must not be puzzled what is an itemized work. Itemized work is nothing but a work costing more than 2.5 crores included in the Pink Book as an item, that is called itemized work. I'll ask the participants now, after my explanation, what is itemized, what is Pink, what is a lump sum, what is an umbrella, then you must be able to tell me. I would like to see how many are interested in this lesson. Okay. So what is an itemized work? Itemized work is a work which was processed through PWP. A work which was processed through PWP, finally shortlisted, and it formed part of the FWP. Then finally it was included in the Pink Book as an itemized, as an item, with the name of work, with the cost, with the grant for that particular financial year. All those details will appear in the Pink Book as an itemized work under each planet. So that is called itemized work. So item number 449 of the Pink Book 2021-22. That means, so this work is appearing in the Pink Book as an item. That is called itemized work. Okay. So while approving the itemized works, what they will do? So out of 100 works, they have shortlisted 10 works and they have included those 10 works as itemized works. So under each plan head, they will also give some lump sum grant. They'll also give some lump sum grant. Some 10 works they have approved, so each one got some 5 crores, 10 crores, or 15 crores, depending on the cost of the work. And then finally, individual works, 10 works, so they have given some 100 crores. And finally, they have given some 25 crores for lump sum grant. Or it may be more also, 50 crores, 100 crores they have given as a lump sum grant. So it is up to the general manager to approve works costing up to 2.5 crores under the lump sum grant. So what the general manager will do, he will distribute that 100 crores or whatever given as a lump sum grant to various. Chaitanya, please tell me, you raised your hand. Chaitanya, are you listening?
Actually, I want to know the difference between umbrella and LSWP.
Sure. I am coming to that.
Yes.
I am coming. Now, as far as the umbrella, lump sum work is concerned, now itemized, you know, what is the itemized work?
Yes, sir.
So now we'll see umbrella, now we'll see lump sum. Okay. Then we'll go to umbrella. So what is the lump sum work? So I was discussing that while approving the work, board has given some lump sum grant at each plan head. So that lump sum grant is distributed among the divisions. So within that lump sum grant, the railways are authorized to approve works up to 2.5 crores. So here also, there are some people are raising hands. Please tell me what is the question? Okay, then what we'll do is we will have these doubts at the end. Okay. Don't raise a hand. You ask. If you want to have a clarification, you directly ask. If you are raising a hand, my diversion, my mind is also getting diverted. So you straight away ask a question. You stop, ask a question.
What is OT works?
I'm coming to that. So now we have seen the itemized work. Now we will see umbrella work first. Lump sum work. So under the lump sum grant, the grant is distributed to various divisions and within the permissible cost, is adopted as per the MSOP, which is not being adopted, that is a different story. But the works under lump sum category, costing up to 2.5 crores, have to be approved either by DRM or GM depending on the delegation of powers. So whatever works approved within that lump sum grant under DRM GM powers is called the lump sum work. Is it clear? Itemized work is over, lump sum work is over. So now comes the umbrella works. So now board said that, see, we are not going to give any itemized works. We are not going to approve any itemized works because of the shortage of funds. They said, but nevertheless, you can send the proposals to us. So the individual railways will send the proposals to the concerned technical directorate, S&T, civil engineering, electrical, deciding a lot of works. So in the board's office, what they will do, in the board's office, technical director, they'll segregate these works. So some 500 works have come from South Central Railway. In that, what is the similar category of works they'll segregate? Like that, they'll see all railways, what are the works have come. So they might have seen that similar category of works are they'll choose. They want to construct a footover bridge at various stations. They have proposed individual items of 500 or 300 works, 200 works, 100 works they have sent. So what they will do, they will segregate those category. They will say FOB is one category, extension of platforms is one category, or TFR is one category, or some amenities work, some repairs to quarters, construction of quarters is one category. So like that, depending on the number of works they propose under various planets, they will subdivide the categories. So now, suppose I am from South Central Railway, I have asked the board to approve some 400 works under various planets. So under planet 5300, I have sent some 50 works. So what they'll do, 50 works are similar works only, similar category of work. I'm asking FOB at every station. I've asked 50 works. So what they'll do, they'll club this item. They'll categorize this item. They'll say, see, Southern Railway, you have asked some 50 works. Most of them are similar category. And you have asked some 500 posts for completion of these works. But 500 posts we don't have. What we will do is we will give you some 100 crores. We will give you 100 crores as an umbrella to you. The works which are prioritized, correct? Suppose priority one work you approve. So the general managers are authorized to approve the work within that 100 crores, depending on your priority, depending on your necessity of the works. So powers have been given to the general managers to approve works under umbrella. And the costing of, again, 2.5 crores each. So, in first instance, he has approved the lump sum works under lump sum category. On the second instance, he is approving works up to 2.5 crores under umbrella category. Umbrella has been given of 100 crores, and then it is up to the general managers to approve works within that umbrella, to accommodate works within that umbrella. So, this is called umbrella work. So, here the idea of the Railway Board is to provide flexibility to the general manager. He can approve work under umbrella during any point of time during the financial year. Any time. But what's happening? As soon as the umbrella is given, complete work. Suppose 100 works, 100 crores have been given by the board. 80 crores only are permitted to be approved by general manager. That 80 crores, immediately within no time, they are getting exhausted, leaving no scope for the further approvals. So suppose some new work comes, they're dropping and then they're doing some juggling and then they're proposing. So this is called umbrella. So lump sum work is different, that is approved under lump sum category. And umbrella works are approved within the umbrella grant given by the Railway Board under each planet, under a specific category of works. Okay, then we have OOT. Chaitanya, is it clear? Umbrella and lump sum?
Yes, sir.
Tell me, what
do
you have
for me? WP for GM and also umbrella. Why two different heads?
Because, we have sent some 100 works now under same category. So, we are not going to approve individual works. Because there is some shortage of funds, I am giving you some lump sum grant to you. Lump sum grant is an umbrella grant to you. Within that you approve. It is a kind of lump sum only. It is a kind of a lump sum. That lump sum grant given under umbrella is being used in a different category. One is the lump sum grant, he is approving his works. And under lump sum also, he is approving the works. So here, one more thing I would like to add here. That under umbrella, he can approve. He can process the works costing more than 2.5 crores. Suppose if he wants an individual work of 50 crores, if he wants an individual work of 25 crores, he can send the proposal to the board. Under umbrella, suppose he has got some 300 crores, in that he can ask some 5-6 works costing more than 2.5 crores also. The only flexibility given, suppose if the work is not costing more than 2.5 crores, you can approve at your level. If it is costing more than 2.5 crores, then you please send the proposal to me, I'll approve it. Initially, duly vetted by finance. See, initially, you have sent the proposal without the vetting of finance. Now, if you want any work to be included in the umbrella, costing more than 2.5 crores, this has to be approved by board. So, it's a different category. Okay, so we have seen the itemized work, we have seen the lump sum, we have seen the umbrella. We also have one more category called out of turn work. Generally, out of turn works, people get confused. It is not connected to your budget. It is not cut. See, itemized works has individual grant. Lump sum work has a grant distributed within the lump sum grant. And umbrella work has a grant within the umbrella given by the government, by the board. And the fourth category, OOT, suppose I want a work on out of turn basis, which I have not processed either in the PWP or in the works program, lump sum works program stage, or during the umbrella stage. So that work I cannot postpone for the next financial year, because if I want to include this, I have to wait for the next financial year, which I can't wait. It is very urgently required, safety consideration. So those works I'm an executive. Those works I can process as out of turn work. So where to get money for that? You don't have any additional money. So what we have to do is, we have to take out the executive. I'm an executive. I'm senior DM coordination. So what I'll do is, I have some itemized works with me. Individual work has some 5 crores, 10 crores. So I will take out some amount, so 50 lakhs from one work, another 25 lakhs from one work. I'll take out 2 crores from 4 or 5 works, and I'll send a proposal to the finance saying, asking him to concur the work, which is very urgent. I cannot wait for the next financial. And the funds required for execution of this work, I'm going to get it from the existing works by way of reappropriation. If I am able to convince the finance, and finance agrees, then I can take up this OT work. And this OT works also, GM can approve up to 2.5 crores. Suppose if it is costing 2.5 crores, more than 2.5 crores, then we need not process the reappropriation. It is up to the board. Suppose if they are agreeing more than 2.5 crores, it is up to them to provide the funds. So when a proposal comes to costing more than 2.5 crores, I don't know, OT, then we should not ask for the funds, reappropriation. It is board will take care of, board finance director will take care of. But we must make a mention that, it should be ensured that the funds required for the OT was costing more than 2.5 crores, required to be reappropriated during the current financial year. So these are the four types of works. One is the itemized works, one is the lump sum works, one is the umbrella works, and the OT works. This is again same slide here. So, what are the various types of estimates, offset estimates? Now we know that we are discussing the works program, and under works program, the offset estimates are processed. The offset estimates are processed for the approval of competent authority, for the administrative approval of competent authority. Once the work is approved, you got the administrative approval of competent authority, then I can go ahead with the preparation of the detailed estimates. Next stage is detailed estimates. So till the work gets included in the budget, till the work gets the administrative approval of the competent authority, I have to process either in the PWP or in the LUMS or in the LSWP or in the works, umbrella works, these four stages. So we will now know what are the various types of offset estimate. People generally, the staff now are not aware. What are PWP is an offset estimate. Pink book is also an offset estimate. LSWP is also an offset estimate. So all this, whatever are mentioned here, various types of survey is an offset estimate. PWP is an offset estimate. FWP is an offset estimate. Pink book is an offset estimate. Lump sum. LAW is also an offset estimate. Out of done works. Umbrella works. So these are nothing but, they are all the examples of the offset estimate. So how these offset estimates are processed through the IRPSM, or how these offset estimates are processed through PWP, which is being processed through IRPSM. So offset estimates are now being processed through IRPSM. The estimates are processed at the divisions and even some headquarters also. Every executive, divisional finance, HOD, PHOD and headquarters finance are given the passwords to examine the proposals. No paperwork. Proposals are downloaded, uploaded, downloaded and examined, and comments are uploaded. Finally, the board takes a decision based on the FNCO's comments provided. They take waiting of FNCO, otherwise it is examined after it is included in the umbrella. So whatever works approved get included in the pink book, law, LSWP. You must also know the difference between pink book, law and LSWP, because most of you have doubt about this. Even I think already working issues also must be having. What is the law? What is the LSWP? Can anybody tell me what is the difference between law and LSWP? Can anybody tell what is the difference between law and LSWP?
102.5 crore in law book and you
point LSWP?
It can be more than 2.5.
See, pink book. Suppose if a work is included in a pink book, that is more than 2.5 crores. It is an itemized one. If it is costing less than 2.5 crores, it can be either LAW or LSWP. Okay. So both LAW and LSWP covers the works costing up to 2.5 crores only. इसमें एक एक minor thing है that you must, everybody must understand. See, I was discussing that GM has powers up to 2.5 crores. So whatever powers he has up to 2.5 crores, he is accruing under lump sum. So it comes as part of the LSWP up to 2.5. But certain planets, like he has powers up to 1 crore for new staff welfare works. Or he has powers to approve the M&P item up to 50 lakhs only. These two categories. So these two categories.
Speaking in your lab.
Please mute your audio. So under these categories, suppose GM is operating up to 1 crore, it is getting included in the LSWP. Suppose if there is a work up to 2 crores exceeding GM's limit and it has to be sent to board, and board, if it approves, then it gets included in the LSWP. Similarly, you have the M&P up to 50 lakhs, he can lump sum M&P, he can approve up to 50 lakhs and it gets included in the LSWP, lump sum M&P. Costing more than 50 lakhs and up to 2.5 crores, it has to be approved by board and it gets included in the LSWP. If it is costing more than 2.5 crores, then it gets included in the pink book. This is what the difference between LSWP and LSWP. And one more thing, we have these umbrella works costing up to 2.5 crores each. Those works we cannot include under LSWP. Those works, whatever approved, have to be included in the list of approved works. So all works, all umbrella works costing up to 2.5 crores, all works pertaining to new staff welfare works costing more than 1 crore to 2.5 crores are required to be included in the LSWP. All other works will go to LSWP. Is it clear? आपको भी पता होना चाहिए, यू मस्ट नो दैट पिंक बुक में क्या होता है, एलएडब्ल्यू में क्या होता है, एलएसडब्ल्यूपी में क्या होता है, ठीक है? इफ एनीबॉडी हैज सम डाउट
प्लीज एक बार बताएं। हाँ,
इसका डिफरेंस ये है, अभी बस कॉस्टिंग मोर देन 2.5 क्रोस हमने डिस्कस कर रहे थे इससे पहले, सो ऑल द बस कॉस्टिंग मोर देन 2.5 क्रोस हैव टू बी सेंट टू बोर्ड फॉर अप्रूवल, बोर्ड ने वो अप्रूव करेगा. Of course, these days no individual works are they are approving, but they are approving umbrella. So they are including in the pink book as an itemized works. So whatever works getting jo bhi works jo pink book mein include hote hain crossing more than 2.5 crores, usko kehte hain pink book itemized work. Usme ek item hota hai, item yani matlab ye work include ho jata hai usme pink book. Usko separate grant diya jata hai. Usko bolte hain pink book itemized work. Aur jo इंडिविजुअल प्लैनेट्स में जो लमसम ग्रांट दिया जाता है, वो लमसम ग्रांट के अंतर्गत जीएम को पावर से 2.5 क्रोस जनरली एक्सेप्ट प्लैनेट 5200, उसमें वो जीएम को पावर से वो विद इन दैट लमसम ग्रांट विद इन सम कॉस्ट सीलिंग भी है, कॉस्ट सीलिंग के अंतर्गत उनको पावर दिया गया है डीआरएम को जीएम को, एंड व्हाट एवर वर्क्स अप्रूव्ड बाय देम वो जो अप्रूव करते हैं उसको एलएसडब्ल्यू में इंक्लूड करते हैं. एक और एक है कैटेगरी लिस्ट ऑफ अप्रूव वर्क्स, उसमें क्या होता है, अभी मान लो न्यू स्टाफ वेलफेयर वर्क्स जी एम को पावर्स है 1 करोड़ के लिए, बाकी के सब वर्क्स में 2.5 है, लेकिन अभी जी एम को 1 करोड़ है लिस्ट ऑफ अप्रूव वर्क्स सॉरी स्टाफ वेलफेयर वर्क्स, तो अप्रूव 1 करोड़ तो मान लो एलएसडब्ल्यू में इंक्लूड कर लेता है, लेकिन 1 करोड़ से 2.5 करोड़ अगर वर्क बीच में 2 करोड़ का वर्क है वो तो पिंक बुक में नहीं इंक्लूड होता है, लेकिन बोर्ड अप्रूव करना पड़ता है. जब बोर्ड अप्रूव करने के बाद उसको लिस्ट ऑफ अप्रूवल्स में एलएडब्ल्यू में डाल देते हैं. अभी आजकल एज पर द रीसेंट मॉडिफिकेशन नाउ द पावर्स ऑफ जनरल मैनेजर्स हैव आल्सो बीन रिड्यूस्ड फॉर प्लैनेट 2938 जो आरओबीज है ना 3800, उसमें पावर्स जनरल मैनेजर के पावर्स भी 1 करोड़ कर दिए गए हैं. इट इज़ नॉट 2.5 crores ना, बिकॉज देर आर लॉट ऑफ इशूज, दि वर्क्स आर गेटिंग अप्रूव एट मैक्सिमम 2.49 crores एंड जब वेरिएशन होता है उसमें, सो इट इज़ गोइंग टू बियॉन्ड 2.5 crores, तो उसमें बहुत सारे एस्टिमेट्स पेंडिंग है. तो इसलिए बोर्ड ने क्या किया है, दि पावर्स ऑफ द रेलवे जी एम हैव बीन रिड्यूस्ड अप टू 1 crore ओनली. सो 1 से 2.5 crores जो भी वर्क्स है वो बोर्ड को भेजना है, बोर्ड अगर अप्रूव करता है तो पिंक बुक में नहीं आता है, वो अप्रूव करने के बाद हम उसको एलएडब्ल्यू में इंक्लूड कर लेते हैं. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एलएडब्ल्यू. एंड जो भी अम्ब्रेला वर्क्स अप्रूव होते हैं वो भी हम इसको अप टू 2.5 क्रोर्स LAW में इंक्लूड करते हैं. दिस इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन बिग बुक आइटम वाइज वर्क्स, LAW वर्क्स एंड लम सम वर्क्स. ठीक है
सर, हैज द पावर ऑफ जीएम अंडर प्लान एट 52 हैज बीन विथड्रॉन?
नहीं नहीं, उसमें सी 5200 इज व्हाट. There is no plan at 5200 now. 5100 में उसको staff welfare कर दिया गया. जो staff quarters and staff amenities no plan होते थे ना पहले, अब उसको क्या कर दिया गया है, एक ही plan कर दिया गया है कि staff welfare. अब वो 5200 में कोई हाई नहीं है, plan is deleted. अब अगर आप मेरा PPT देखेंगे तो उसमें आप मैं कट कर दिया हूँ. उसमें ये 5100 is only staff welfare. वो staff welfare में GM 2.5 क्रोर्स तक एग्जिस्टिंग वर्क, अभी आपका एक हॉस्पिटल है उसमें कुछ इम्प्रूवमेंट करना है तो 2.5 क्रोर्स तक कर सकता है. लेकिन सपोज ये न्यू क्लिनिक बनाना है, एक नए स्टेशन पे न्यू क्लिनिक, न्यू स्टाफ वेलफेयर है, उसका पावर्स हैं अप टू 1 क्रोर. एनी न्यू, सपोज यू वांट टू कंस्ट्रक्ट अ न्यू कम्युनिटी हॉल, इफ इट इज कॉस्टिंग मोर देन 1 क्रोर इट हैज टू गो बोर्ड. इट इज अप टू 1 क्रोर, जीएम कैन डू दैट.
ओके सर, थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू सर.
ठीक है, सो दिस इज दी process and then ye humne letter discuss kar liya already. This is the works program every year ye aata hai, text yahi rehta hai basically. Isme mujhe bhai aap video works last 3-4 saal se to yahi ho rahi ke don't propose any works and isme ye bhi likha hua hai ke aapko waiting ki visa karane ki zarurat nahi hai, aap pehle bhej do, hum usko examine karenge aur include kar lenge as an umbrella, subsequently it can be vetted. नितीश बताएं क्या बात है
सर. वन मोर क्वेश्चन, यू आर सेइंग दैट विदाउट वेटिंग द पीडब्ल्यूपी सेंट टू रेलवे बोर्ड एंड सबसिक्वेंटली इट इज गॉट वेटेड एट रेलवे बोर्ड लेवल. तो वंस रेलवे बोर्ड हैज अप्रूव्ड द वर्क, व्हाट इज द नेसेसिटी ऑफ गेटिंग इट वेटेड एट रेलवे बोर्ड? रेलवे
बोर्ड वेटिंग नहीं, एक्चुअली जनरली क्या है,
मैकेनिकल वाला होता है और एक कमर्शियल वाला. So these people are on the planet called Dennis. But commercial law like a planet called Samana, compatibilization of Dianne, and those car. 5300 भी वो उसका अरे इज इम्पोर्टेंट तो इलेक्ट्रिकल में कौन से होते हैं इलेक्ट्रिकल बॉक्स ऑल इलेक्ट्रिकल्स एस एन टी में प्लैनेट 3300 प्लैनेट 1600 में होते हैं प्योर एस एन टी वर्क सो देर आर डिफरेंट प्लान हेड कोऑर्डिनेटर्स इन द डिवीजन लाइक सी डी डी एम ई सी डी डी सी डी डी एस टी एंड दिस सी डी सी डी एन कोऑर्डिनेशन ठीक है तो वो लोग क्या करते हैं proposals will include planet coordinators are responsible for creation of new proposals. They are responsible for their respective planet. Proposals will include planet, name of work, abstract cost, breakup, justification. They will write, noting, attach, sketch, plan and mark to the other concerns. I mean, one planet coordinator has a civil engineering, has a SNTP, so two different coordinators mark. So they will examine it. Then finally, they will send it to the CNDFM for concurrence. सो सी एन डी एफ एम कंकरेंस देता है और वेटिंग देता है देन उसके बाद वो वापस उसको भेज देता है कि भाई तुम्हारा प्रपोजल इज वेटेड और नॉट वेटेड और रिटर्न विद सम ऑब्जर्वेशन तो जो प्लैनेट कोऑर्डिनेटर क्या करता है वो प्रपोजल को देन ही विल सेंड इट टू दी अब यहाँ वेटिंग हो गया उसके बाद ही विल सेंड इट टू दी सीरिडियन कोऑर्डिनेशन इज दी कोऑर्डिनेटिंग प्लैनेट इज दी नोडल ऑफिसर इज द नोडल ऑफिसर इन द डिवीजन तो वहाँ पर वो क्या करते हैं वो उसको एग्जामिन करके देन ही विल प्रोसेस द अप्रूवल ऑफ द डीआरएम टू द हेडक्वार्टर्स सो ही कैन आल्सो मेक सम ऑब्जर्वेशन बिकॉज ही इज द नोडल ऑफिसर ही कैन आस्क क्वेश्चंस टू द अदर प्लैनेट कोऑर्डिनेटर्स ही कैन आस्क देम टू रिड्यूस द कॉस्ट ही कैन सो ही इज अ नोडल ऑफिसर सो ही हैज सम पावर्स सो ही कैन डू दैट मान लो सब कुछ ठीक है वो प्रोसेस कर लेगा डीआरएम का मुंह ले लेगा और अपने प्लैनेट कोऑर्डिनेटर्स को भेज देंगे दिल के लिए गो टू द सीएसटी वी गो टू द पीसी वी गो टू द कंसर्न टू बी ए छोटी सी थी हेडक्वार्टर्स तो डिवीजन में प्लैनेट कोऑर्डिनेटर्स वी नोडल ऑफिसर इट इज वेटेड बाय द सीनेटिव सर ये पूरा किस पे हो रहा है प्रोसेस ऑन एआरपी डिटेल प्रोसेस आई हैव ऑलरेडी ब्रॉट आउट इन दिस स्लाइड्स यू कैन जस्ट गो थ्रू दैट if you are working in finance section or if you are preparing for some examination. So this will help you. So after the proposal is examined in the division, you go to the headquarters. So here we are talking only about the proposals costing more than 2.5 crores. Because if PWP bhi jata hai, proposal board ko, more than 2.5 crores hi jata hai. So less than 2.5 crores, uska next process aata hai, jab LSWP chalta hai, wo bhi IRP se mein aata hai. जब अम्ब्रेला वर्क चलते हैं वो भी आर पी एस में आता है सो दैट इज अ डिफरेंट प्रोसेस सो यहाँ कॉस्टिंग मोर देन 2.5 क्रोर्स यहाँ पर डिविजन में इनिशियल मीटिंग हो गया सो हेडक्वार्टर्स चला गया हेडक्वार्टर्स में भी हेडक्वार्टर्स वाले भी हेडक्वार्टर्स जो पी एच ओ डी होते हैं वहाँ पर भी जो प्लैनेट कोऑर्डिनेटर्स होते हैं वो भी अपने तरफ से वर्क प्रोसेस कर सकते हैं जनरली वी कम फ्रॉम द ग्रास रूट लेवल फ्रॉम द सी एन डी ई लेवल आता है लेकिन हेडक्वार्टर्स में भी कर सकते हैं वो लोग लेकिन आल्सो डू प्रपोजल रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द एंटायर रेलवेज सो वट एवर प्रपोजल्स आर डन बाई द प्लैनेट कोऑर्डिनेटर्स दे विल बी सेंड टू दी पी एफ ए फॉर वेटिंग पी एफ ए के पास वेटिंग ना आज के दिन वेटिंग नहीं है लेकिन जनरली वेटिंग फाइनेंस वेटिंग होगा एफ एन सी ओ उसको वेट करेगा अपने कमेंट देंगे एग्जामिन करके वट आर दी एफ एन सी वर्क कमेंट सी लेटर उसका जो भी वेटेड he can return the proposal duly vetted he can return the proposal with check note also or without vetting also he can examine the proposals so FNCO ka vetting ho gaya baad mein phir wapas chala gaya coordinator ke paas chala gaya jo planet coordinator sir so planet coordinator kya karte hain again they are sent to nodal officer in the headquarters is the CEPN chief engineer planning and designs so CPD bhi bolte hain usko chief planning design engineer bhi bolte hain or CEPN some railways they call CEPND, some railways they call CPD. So वहाँ पर after the is being vetted by the PFA they say तो CPD क्या करता है वो भी because he's a road officer वो भी examine कर सकता है अगर कोई discrepancy है तो उसको return कर सकता है then सब कुछ ठीक है तो he'll put up to the proposal to the general manager तो PC इनका जो boss होता है principal chief engineer वहाँ से he'll put up to the general manager and with the approval of general manager it will be sent to the कोर्ट जी एम का जो उसका ड्यूटीज है वो करेगा इसकी सभी मैं लिस्ट आउट किया हूँ दिस टू स्लाइड्स व्हाट आर दी व्हाट इज दी एक्सरसाइज डन बाय दी सीबीडी व्हाट इज दी एक्सरसाइज डन बाय दी पीसीई एंड देन वंस दी जीएम अप्रूव्स देन द प्रपोजल्स बियॉन्ड सैंक्शनिंग पावर ऑफ जनरल मैनेजर विल बी फॉरवर्डेड टू ईडीसीई एग्जीक्यूटिव डायरेक्टर सिविल इंजीनियरिंग जनरल रेलवे बोर्ड ही इज दी नोडल ऑफिसर इन दी बोर्ड फॉर वर्क्स प्रोग्राम तो जीएम कैन क्रिएट लीजिए तो हम ऑफकोर्स ये कर सकते हैं वर्क्स प्रोग्राम में सो इन रेलवे बोर्ड क्या होता है अभी यहाँ से प्रपोजल डिवीजन से हेडक्वार्टर्स आए हेडक्वार्टर्स से देन बोर्ड चला गया बोर्ड में क्या होता है EDCEG will receive online new proposals sent by Zone Railway views and will forward to the respective nodal directors. Log kya karte hain apne apne nodal directors bhejte hain. So that will be examined in the nodal directorate. Oh, nodal director kya karte hain usko bhi aajkal nodal directors they are picking up the umbrella works and they are suggesting okay instead of these works you do these umbrella works. So whatever the work suggested by the nodal directors EDCE usko AMS committee ko prove karta hai. So finally जो PWP में जितने भी वर्क्स आते हैं वो AMS कमेटी शॉर्टलिस्ट करता है उसको उसके बाद फाइनली शॉर्टलिस्टेड एंड प्रपोजल्स विल बी सेंड टू दी EDCE वापस उनको भेजते हैं सो EDCE ने रेलवे को बोलता है भाई आपके प्रपोजल्स ये शॉर्टलिस्ट हुए हैं इसका आप उसको FWP बनाइए यू मेक दी FWP फॉर दिस शॉर्टलिस्टेड प्रपोजल एंड देन अकॉर्डिंगली दी FWP इज मेड देन अगेन सेंड टू बोर्ड बोर्ड विल एग्जामिन दोस प्रपोजल्स एंड देन इट इसमें इंक्लूड करेगा PWP So these are all the process I have listed out here, which will be useful to you for working in the section as well as for writing the examination. Okay, so the process is done. The process of PWP is done through IRPSM, and it is examined. It is processed at various level. It is examined at various level, and it is approved at various levels. Okay, but today we should also discuss about the IRPSM shortcomings. IRPSM क्या है इट इज़ अ प्रोसेस फॉर PWP बट देर आर सम शॉर्ट कमिंग्स ऑल्सो एस्पेशली फॉर लम सम वर्क्स प्रोग्राम फॉर वी विल सी व्हाट आर दोज शॉर्ट कमिंग्स सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल पहले जब प्रपोजल्स आते थे वेन एवर वी यूज टू गेट द प्रपोजल्स वी यूज टू गेट विद सम शॉर्ट कमिंग्स लाइक एडिक्वेट डिटेल्स आर नॉट अवेलेबल द बेसिस फॉर द कास्ट हैज नॉट बीन इंडिकेटेड द रफ स्केचेस हैव नॉट बीन हम इसको रिटर्न करते थे आजकल क्या है एवरीथिंग इज अपलोडेड ऑन दी वेबसाइट एंड द प्रपोजल्स आर डाउनलोड अपलोडेड एट लास्ट मोमेंट सपोज कल बोर्ड को कल जानी है प्रपोजल्स लास्ट डेट इज टुमारो एंड द IRPSM इज गेटिंग क्लोज टुमारो तो आज आ जाते हैं प्रपोजल्स ऑफ फाइनेंस में सो दे फाइनेंस पीपल दे डोंट हैव एनी टाइम टू एग्जामिन दोस प्रपोजल्स सो फर्स्ट द डेफिशिएंसी इज द इनसफिशिएंट डिटेल्स Sketches, rough plans, basis for the cost are not being made available. All the proposals dumped on finance just before the last day. Cost ceilings so forward not being made available. भाई आपके जो proposals process करने से पहले आपको cost ceiling आपके जो proposal है, proposal should be within your cost ceiling. But those cost ceiling, those so forward details are not being made available. And above all, the IRPSM is not एक मेड फुल प्रूफ नहीं है उसमें जो भी थ्रो फॉरवर्ड आज मैं बता रहा हूँ कि टुडे द थ्रो फॉरवर्ड आई एम शोइंग लाइक 400 क्रोस टुमारो आई कैन रिड्यूस इट टू 350 क्रोस सो इसमें इट इज नॉट फुल प्रूफ वी कांट रिले ऑन द फिगर्स ऑफ थ्रो फॉरवर्ड सबमिटेड बाय द एक्सपेंडिचर्स सो सीलिंग्स डू नॉट टेक द थ्रो फॉरवर्ड एक्सपेंडिचर नॉट फुलफिलिंग द रिक्वायर्ड पर्पज फॉर इट इज क्रिएटेड अभी एक ही एडवांटेज है इसका IRPSM का no paper work and manual hours are saved yahi advantage hai but otherwise regarding the verification part regarding the details it is not fulfilling much purpose it is only being used for processing online for purposes of works in the PWP LRPP OT and umbrella works suggestion de sakte hain ki bhai there should be an inbuilt checklist for the requisite details without which the proposal shall not be further processed. भाई इसमें checklist होना चाहिए there should be some checklist. Sufficient details like sketch, duly signed by the field engineer, duly signed by the headquarters engineer. And the second one is the cost, based on what is the basis for this cost.
what is the justification, whether ROR is submitted or not, rate of return. So there should be some checklist without which the proposal should not be allowed to be in further process. Then only this IRPC can be fulfilled. And most importantly, the permissible cost concept included in MSOP is not being adhered to. There, the formula as per the MSOP is that grant into norm minus throw forward. But the formula being adopted in IRPSM is the grant into norm. Throw forward is thrown to air. So it is not being considered. So what is happening? The throw forward is getting added to the every year. So last year I have got some permissible cost of 500 crores. So I had a throw forward of 300 crores. So suppose if I reduce 300 crores, my permissible cost only will be 200 crores. But I am not taking those 300 crores away. I am also keeping the 300 crores. That means I am adding 300 crores every year to the throw forward. It is taking huge tally. So that is the reason why the bills are pending at any point of time. Huge bills are pending in divisions. So that permissible cost is being ignored. That is the major deficiency in the IRPS. So this is the checklist and we have to check these proposals. Suppose if there is no vetting this time for PWP, but there is checklist and there is a proposal still exists, that the proposals under LSWP and proposals under umbrella are to be pre-vetted. So iske liye checklist hum dekhte hain. So whenever proposal comes to finance, either a PWP or a lump sum works or a umbrella, so what is that we should see? We should see that the administrative approval exists or not. Before the proposal is sent, there is some procedure. Proposal has to be vetted by somebody, because GM, before this lump sum works program or before this umbrella works, he will have a meeting. He will approve. Executives, the PHODs will propose a lot of works, but he will say they will be shortlisted by GM. So if it is shortlisted, that means it has the administrative approval of general. So that will insist that each and every proposal should have the approval. Then we should also see the works are within permissible cost. This is what I was discussing. The permissible cost is BG into NAM minus throw forward. But as per the IRPSM, this throw forward is not being considered at all. This is a major deviation. We have to actually raise it on appropriate level. By removing this throw forward, we are adding huge amount of commitments every year. So it is our duty to work out the throw forward also, because in the IRPSM now, these days we can work out the throw forward. Even if they are not showing, we can know what are the works in progress. So we will know what is the expenditure incurred. Then balance is the throw forward. So we should work out the permissible cost, and we should be able to tell the executives, say, sir, you have sent these many proposals, but they are beyond your permissible cost. Your permissible cost is only 50 crores. So at the most, I can agree up to 20 works. So your 100 works, I am not going to agree. So we'll make a mention. The proposal has been examined, and as per the MSOP, the permissible cost has been worked out to only 50 crores. So it is requested, it is advised, not requested, it is advised to prioritize these works and see that the works within the permissible cost only can be approved. So this is an important task the finance has to do these days. Otherwise, it will go on added to the... So we will make an observation. It is up to the DRM, it is up to the general manager to take a decision. Let him take a decision, let him approve the works beyond the permissible cost. It is up to him. But our duty is to make the observation. For each and every work, we must work out the permissible cost and give it to the approving authority. And we should see that the works are within the framework of policy, initiated at grassroots level, cost based on the current market prices. They should be updated with a view to keep it below 2.5 crores. They'll not update the cost. They'll see that the work is approved by underestimating it. So we must see whether the cost is underestimated or not. If it is evident that the cost is underestimated, then we must make a mention in our proposals. generally these offset estimates are based on the major quantities for major value items. So board has said that the major value items based on rough sketches plans to be signed by the field and headquarters officers. A plan, a sketch has to be drawn and they should certify that the quantities and the for the major value items have been verified, and this can be executed without major modification during the execution. The certification has to be made by a field executive and headquarters. By these words, what we are going to assume? See, there is a fear now among the executives. He is certifying. Tomorrow, suppose he varies, he will be held responsible. So at least we must insist that all these proposals, whether it is LWP, whether it is umbrella, the executive should certify that the quantities or major value items should be based on the plans and drawings, and it can be executable without a major modification. And there are allocation of expenditures, source of fund, of course, this is our responsibility, realistic estimation, minimum cost, no or over provisioning, reasonable assumptions, ROR also we must take. And wherever justification is required, we must see for these items, staff amenities, passenger amenities, work required for operational efficiency, safety consideration, we don't see the ROR. And finally, we will make a mention whether it is verbatim comments of FNCO or verbatim comments of CIDF, because these days the powers have been given, most of the powers have been given to DRMs. So it is up to the CIDF to make comments. So he can make comments on the merit and the justification of the proposal. He can make comments on the reasonableness of the rates, quantities, particularly high value items. He can make comments on the ROR. He can make comments on the permissible cost. These are the things we must examine at the time of scrutiny and make comments in the FNCO's vetting or scrutiny consultant. So based on justification, available funds, position and FNCO's comments or CIDF's comments, the Railway Board, GM takes a decision. If approved by Commerce Authority, the work gets included in the budget, being booked as itemized work and specific grant for the year. So umbrella works we already discussed. There are 3-4 slides. If you want further details, you can refer to these umbrella slides. And then we have lump sum works also. I have brought out all the latest provisions here. Lump sum, what is the power? One thing I have not updated, the latest, very recently, letter board has issued a letter limiting the GM's powers to 1 crore for the plan at 3000, that is the ROVs and ROVs. So there also powers have been reduced to up to 1 crore. That you please make a correction to this. Board we already discussed. And this is the summary, survey estimates costing more than 150 crores. 2.5 crores costing more than 2.5 crores required to send and to be included in the book. Umbrella, lump sum, OT I have discussed. So this was the process of PWB. The PWB is nothing but a memory works program wherein the abstract estimates are being processed for the approval of competent authority, whether it is GM or it is board, and the proposals are being processed to IRPSM. And once it is shortlisted, then PWB becomes the FWB, and then the FWB will be the basis for the bidding book, and whatever shortlisted works will be included in the bidding book. And in the bidding book, lump sum grant will be given. From the lump sum grant, lump sum works will be approved, and from the umbrella works, GMI support. So this is the process. So any doubts?
Thank you, sir.
Sir, this means sir, sanction estimate होने के बाद उसको part by करके quotation से work किया जा सकता है।
Sir, ये आप अभी offset estimate हो गया, then you are talking about the detail estimate के बाद आप क्या करें?
Estimate sanction होने के बाद उसको क्या करते हैं sir? Part करके quotation से work कर देते हैं जब तक tender नहीं होता है।
जी, actually क्या है? हाँ, I understood. Deliberately, they will try to bring it within 10 lakhs and then उसको split करके quotation basis पे award करते हैं, ये करते हैं। तो उसमें क्या होता है? आपके पास proposal आएगा ना? You finance will get the proposal, no? So finance will get the proposal. That time you will object in saying that, see, कोटेशन कब बना सकते हैं हम कोटेशन? When the work is very urgent.
When the work is very urgent, then only quotations can be invited. And suppose आपने 2.5 crores का एक 2.2 crores का एक work sanction कर लिया, detail estimate sanction कर लिया, तो normally you must go for ये single one tender for that. You must go for a tender so that you get some good competitive rate.
But ये लोग क्या करते हैं? They'll split the work. As you said, they'll split the work and send to you for finance concurrence. So that time you object. आप जब बोलिए कि भाई ये जो आपका प्रपोजल है इट इज नॉट ट्रू स्पिरिट ऑफ दैट अवार्ड ऑफ फॉर ट्रांसपोर्टेशन बेसिस, सो इसको एग्जामिन कर दिया जाए, इसको रिटर्न कर दिया जाए. एक बार रिटर्न करो देन राइट व्हाई दे आर डूइंग. सो वी हैव अथॉरिटी, वी हैव राइट टू क्वेश्चन बिकॉज इट रिक्वायर्स फाइनेंस का प्रायर फाइनेंस का करेंट. कोटेशन बुलाने के बाद वो नहीं आएगा, कोटेशन बुलाने से पहले वो आपके पास आएगा.
जी थैंक यू सर.
जी
थैंक यू सर.
जनरिक
सर, सर व्हाट इज सैंक्शन कॉस्ट, वेदर वी हैव टू टेक अब्स्ट्रैक्ट एस्टीमेट कॉस्ट और डिटेल एस्टीमेट कॉस्ट?
सी अब्स्ट्रैक्ट एस्टीमेट कॉस्ट इज एन अप्रूव्ड कॉस्ट, इट इज एन एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव अप्रूवल. वंस इट इज अप्रूव्ड थ्रू पीडब्ल्यूबी एफडब्ल्यूबी इट इज एन अब्स्ट्रैक्ट कॉस्ट, इट इज एन अप्रूव्ड कॉस्ट एंड इंक्लूडेड कॉस्ट इन द क्लीन बुक. सो दैट इज once it is approved, it is not approved, the upside is met. It is not a sanction cost. Okay, so aapka question mein samajh liya, which one do you call it a sanction cost, whether it is upside cost, whether it is technical cost?
Yes,
bolie na.
Yes sir.
So ek bar ek cost approve hota hai ping book mein, that is for our purpose, it is an approved cost, it is approved cost only, but people will call it as an upside cost also. वो ठीक नहीं है. देर इज एन अपलोड कॉस्ट, स्टिल इज एन अपलोड कॉस्ट. सो सैंक्शन कॉस्ट कौन सा होता है? व्हेन द डिटेल एस्टीमेट इज प्रिपेयर्ड एंड टेक्निकली सैंक्शन, सो दैट विल बी द लास्ट सैंक्शन कॉस्ट. बट ओरिजिनल सैंक्शन कॉस्ट वाज द अपलोड कॉस्ट, देन सब्सिक्वेंट सैंक्शन कॉस्ट वाज द कॉस्ट विच हैज बीन सैंक्शन बेस्ड ऑन द टेक्निकल डिटेल एस्टीमेट, सो दैट इज सैंक्शन कॉस्ट. उसके बाद में और एक कॉस्ट होता है रिवाइज एस्टीमेट में, जब भी डिटेल एस्टीमेट बनता है दैट इज द लास्ट सैंक्शन. सो लेटेस्ट सैंक्शन इज रिवाइज एस्टीमेट, लास्ट सैंक्शन इज द डिटेल एस्टीमेट, इनिशियल अप्रूवल इज द ऑफसेट कॉस्ट.
सर वन मोर डाउट सर. सर दीस आर ऑल थिंग्स सर, ऑफसेट एस्टीमेट, डिटेल एस्टीमेट, रिवाइज एस्टीमेट.
यस
दीस आर ऑल द थिंग्स सर नॉट बीइंग फीचर्ड इन आईएमपीएसएम. सो दैट फॉर डूइंग दिस कंप्लीशन रिपोर्ट.
यस
these are all not being not at all appearing sir.
Yeah, they are only saying last sanction cost they are saying.
So yes,
there are some inconsistencies. This is also one of the inconsistencies. They can say anticipated cost.
Yes sir.
The approved cost is some 2 crores, but they'll say anticipated cost is 2.49 crores.
And yes,
they say it is 2.7 crores. It is not approved.
Yes sir.
So that is not correct. So the IRPSM is not, that's why I said it is not approved.
There are some loopholes. There are some figures which can be altered without the finance meeting. So that's why I said any alteration, once it is figuring, when any item is figuring in the IR base of for any alteration, they should consult the finance. Then only it can be made full proof.
Yes, sir. Again, sir, this completion report.
Okay.
Can we follow IR base of portal? Or we have to do it manually? Because work register we are not at all maintaining.
So you are not maintaining?
Yes sir.
Then where do you draw the CR?
Based on the executive's work register.
Achha. Okay. Somewhere it is, one set of register is being maintained.
Yes sir.
Okay. So that if that is being reconciled now and then? No. At least you are verifying. See, there are two sets of works registers, there is one set of works registers. Two sets of works register, he has to sign in our register, we have to sign in their register. So if it is only one set of register, then we have to sign, both of us have to sign in the same register. So you see, you ensure that it is reconciled, even if it is a single set of register, it has to be reconciled. So we have to draw in their register only. We have to draw this here in their register, based on the sanction cost, based on the you don't depend on the IRP, so we can question. You suppose if sanction cost is 2 crores and they are showing 2.4 crores,
that you don't in rely on the IRPSM because it is not fully proof. So you can insist the latest cost as based on the documents. Okay. So thank you very much. So we will call it a day.
Sir, one more question.
Tell me.
The umbrella works total cost ceiling limit and LSWP total cost ceiling limit kuda idi mee book lo nestaru
the ceiling limits they are supposed to be given in the ARPSM but those ceiling limits they are not following because as per the MSOP the ceiling is different that is norm that is granted to norm minus throw forward as per the ARPSM the throw forward is not considered.
టోటల్ అమౌంట్ ఇస్తున్నారు ఈ ఫైనాన్షియల్ ఇయర్ అనేది మీ బుక్ లో
ఉంటుంది దాంట్లో 80%
మరి ఈ ఎల్ఎస్డబ్ల్యూపీకి ప్లానెడ్ వైజ్ గా డబ్బులు ఇస్తారని చెప్తారు
ఒకవేళ
ఏదైనా వర్క్ ఈ అంబ్రెల్లా వర్క్ కింద కానీ ప్లాన్ కింద కానీ వస్తే దాన్ని ఎందులో అనేది ఎట్లా
మరి చెప్పండి మరి చెప్పండి
ఒకవేళ ఏదైనా వర్క్ ఉంది అనుకోండి సార్ అది సేమ్ వే అంబ్రెల్లా వర్క్ కిందకి వచ్చింది ఒకవేళ ఏదైనా ప్లాన్ కింద కూడా వస్తే
జనరల్ గా రిపిటేషన్ అవుతుంది రిపిటేషన్ బట్ బేసికలీ దే ఆర్ దే రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ కాదు దే కాంట్ ప్రపోజ్ ది పర్సన్ అండర్ లంసమ్ యాజ్ వెల్ అండర్ అంబ్రెల్ దే కాంట్
Now 5100 and 5200 both plan heads have been merged now sir.
Yes,
so yes. There is no separate plan head for staff quarters or it should be provided under
there is no staff quarters, there is no staff abilities, no. It is the staff welfare. The nomenclature is staff welfare. So if you want to propose the staff quarters, if you want to propose any welfare work, you have to process in that 5100 only.
Okay sir. And one more thing sir, under umbrella works, the list of works approved. Yeah. Will be again sent to railway board just like list of approved works
LAW. Yeah. Yeah, they have to be included in the LAW. They have to all the works under umbrella after approval they have to be included in the LAW for the purpose of monitoring the total grant of the umbrella. So it has to be properly sent to board. See you have given a umbrella of 200 crores. So within the 200 crores we have approved these many works costing up to 160 crores. So we have to tell it to board, it's a feedback. So all these works which have been included in the LAW have been submitted to the board saying that against your umbrella we have got this approved.
And umbrella provision will be plan head wise or it will be?
It is the item wise one. It is under each item of umbrella, not plan head.
And sir, 80 crores only GM can approve works up to 80 crores.
80%.
And balance 20% for emergencies, sir.
Emergency, nahi. Suppose board has thought that if I give 100 crores, 100% to these people, there will be some cost exceeding the sanction limit. So they kept some cushion. They kept some cushion to cover these excess overspend, and also any proposal requiring that 20% have to be approved by them. So suppose if you want work within that 20%. Then you will have to submit your proposal to the board. That time you have to say what is the cost, how many works have approved, what is the expenditure incurred. So that time we will see whether this cost is within that 100% or not. So that is the only question to control the cost.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Anybody else?
Thank you.
For the creation of salt production unit.
Creation of? Which plan had you made? MS 16 only. That capital segment only. Capital segment, new division will come under 6400 for the specified works, and the production unit will come under 5200.
sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Srinivas Puluri, raised hand. What is the problem? What is the question? Srinivas? Okay, anyway. Thank you. Thanks a lot,
sir. Sir, good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Thank you so much, sir.
Sir, I just want to know, ये umbrella bus जो है,
जी जी,
lump sum grant के बाद, actually आज जोरनवेल पे circular getting umbrella bus grant है, तो
yes, umbrella grant separate नहीं आता है,
हाँ, umbrella grant separate नहीं आता है, जो आपका जो itemized works में, उसको include करते हैं as a umbrella, they'll give some cost for the similar category of work, that is called umbrella.
But the very idea of umbrella work is a
similar nature of work. That's what.
Similar nature is similar category.
Similar category.
That is it, sir.
Even across the
all similar category works only will be included in the umbrella.
And across the zonal railways also they are happening. So that is it, sir. You just comment.
Sir, you are saying that
there is zonal
railway in lump sum also.
That is it, sir. Similar nature of work, sir. Across the various zonal railways, umbrella marks they are coming under.
See, there are three types of umbrella. If you see my slides, I have not discussed the three types of umbrella. One is Mahamali railways, one is within your railway, and one is the new projects like new lines, doubling. So, one umbrella can be granted for taking up the survey of new lines. Under capital segment, that is for major projects. And the second category is, suppose you want to provide the escalators at major stations. So that can be included in one of the railways. Northern Railway they included. Provision of escalators at various stations.
On Indian Railways.
So that is a second type of umbrella. Third type is, within your railway. Within your railway, see, FOBs. So you can take up the different FOBs under one umbrella.
So there are,
if you read my slides, your doubt will be clear.
Thank you very much, sir. Happy to hear you.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Sundar, I will speak now.
Yeah, you, sir. 1 minute. I propose a vote of thanks and then you can
speak. Okay.
On behalf of Sitara, we thank Mr. Afzaluddin for his wonderful lecture. And also clarifying doubts of all the participants. We have a small announcement. We have observed in the videos that some of the participants are not observing the minimum decorum. This is a meeting which is viewed by officers and staff across the Indian Railways. Therefore, we request all the participants to maintain the minimum decorum even if they are during the Zoom meeting from their house. And also tomorrow's meeting topic will be classification expenditure. This is a very important topic. It involves day-to-day use of various allocations and various expenditure. And I thank all the participants for attending today's meeting. Tomorrow, the login meeting starts at 11:30. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Bye. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.